I would say some of the best research is on quercetin. And you know, what is quercetin? It's well, besides being one of my all-time favorite supplements going on 35 years, that's I've been prescribing it for that long, is a yellow pigment that's found in most fruits and vegetables, but especially rich in apple skins and onions, especially red onion skins. So, you know, onion soup is a really good source of quercetin. But most people, if they're eating salads, they're getting quercetin. So, you know, you're already eating it in your diet. But it was discovered years and years ago that quercetin is a really good immune supportive agent. Some of the early research was on allergies, because quercetin stabilizes a type of white blood cell called mast cells. Mast cells release histamine. Histamine is what causes all that nasal congestion and sneezing that you get with allergies and with a cold. The one thing about quercetin is that it's very poorly absorbed. So you have to take a lot of it if you're just buying straight quercetin powder. We're talking 3,000 milligrams or so a day. But there was a study on quercetin phytosome, which is quercetin that's bound to sunflower lecithin. And that study showed that it dramatically enhanced the absorption of the quercetin. So if you're taking quercetin phytosome, you need generally one or two caps once or twice a day. It's, you know, inexpensive, safe, non-toxic. Kids can take it. Little kids can take it. So it's my top supplement where I just think everyone should take this. And then, you know, if there's any indication that an infection is coming on, you can triple that dose. You can do like 500 three times a day. Frank, you use quercetin, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, I've been using it more often now, but I haven't used it as much as you do, but I do. And now I've been taking it as well. But I use it, but I'm actually starting to use the Thorne, you know, quercetin phytosome, because as you said, it's better absorbed. I've usually been using it in other formulas, and obviously it's not enough, but thanks for that.
You know, there's a pretty good reason to believe that that quercetin is a worthwhile thing. Now, I'm not saying, hey, just take the quercetin and you're done. I'm just saying that's the top of my list, right? I think the more the merrier. It's like, this is a soup here of immune supportive agents.
You know, vitamin D obviously is one of those nutrients. Also, you can measure it. You know, we see so many people have low vitamin D, so we can assume that most people need vitamin D. What I'm actually recommending to people who don't have their levels measured, just take 5,000 a day in the meantime anyway. 5,000 a day, although some people say it's too much. I've never seen a overdose on 5,000 at all. The most important thing with vitamin A and vitamin D is they're fat soluble. So what I hear all the time, people take it and they're taking it with a salad, or they're not taking it with fat, and then it's not going to be absorbed. So the important thing about A and D, you need to take it with fat. Otherwise, you're not going to get any D into you.
So the interesting thing about vitamin D is that if the immune system is under functioning, and you add vitamin D, it brings the immune system up to normal functioning level. But if it's over functioning, it actually down regulates, it decreases the activity of vitamin D, which is why it's been used for autoimmune diseases like multiple sclerosis, right? So vitamin D is, you know, you could call it an adaptogen. It's really a hormone, not, you know, we think of it as a dietary supplement, but it's working like a hormone that regulates the immune system. Now, this is an important point because I saw a paper that came out of the University of Arizona Integrative Medical Center where they were saying, you know, be really careful with vitamin D because it could cause a cytokine storm in people that have COVID-19. You know what? I've never seen one pub study that says that this happens. Right, it's totally fantasy. There's also a pretty famous nutritionist named Chris Masterjohn, who says if you're taking vitamin D and you get COVID-19, you better stop it immediately, or your immune system's going to go haywire. There's no evidence that that happens. There's just none, and so it's total speculation. I'm seeing a lot of this kind of speculation out there. Don't take elderberry. if you've got COVID because it'll make your immune system go haywire. Well, show me the evidence. You know, if you take your immune cells and put them in a test tube and add some elderberry, it activates the immune cells. Well, that's what you want. That doesn't mean that herbs like elderberry or echinacea or andrographis or any of these immune boosting herbs, that doesn't mean that if you take them, you know, over a period of days, that your immune system is going to get boosted into the universe. You know, it's not going to skyrocket into the universe. It's not, it doesn't work that way. It's a fundamental misunderstanding of how these herbs work.